He gets me around.
Yeah, it's efficient.
Yeah.
Battery-operated?
Well, of course it's battery-operated, yeah. How else am I going to operate it?
How many hours could we go on it?
It goes about 30 miles on a charge.
Wow,
yeah.
Does it hurt your back?
Why would it hurt my back?
You know, kind of like...
Doesn't that require you to move, like, towards this way to stop it?
It's just the way you lean, that's all. Yeah, yeah. What are you guys doing?
We're Jehovah's Witnesses. We're here for those that are interested in knowing what the Bible says.
I read it. I know what it says. Unless you're talking about a different Bible.
No.
Oh, okay. Oh, okay.
It's all about applying it.
About what?
Helping people to apply it.
Apply it.
Yeah.
Principles that are found there to help us to get through difficulties with either challenges or questions that people have. What is the purpose of life? Why is there so much
purpose of life? Isn't that relative to the person? Its purpose and meaning is you know, what each person, the definition is what each person decides it is, right?
But do you believe that you were created?
My parents had sex. I mean, that's that's how I came to be. Well, I don't know what you mean by created.
Some people believe in evolution.
Well, evolution is a fact. It's not whether it's a belief or not. I mean, it's... If you don't believe in evolution?
It's a theory, and no, I don't believe in it.
We know what a theory is. It's a conclusion based on facts, right?
How do you...
A theory is a conclusion based on the... It has facts to back it up. A theory is very... I think you're trying to say it's hypothesis, and that's different. A theory is based on facts.
Okay. So my only thing is, why is it we're not continuing?
We are. We are. It's just that we live such short lives, we don't really see the drastic changes that we are able to evidence through what we see in DNA and fossil. We live a very short amount of time. What's that?
It should be getting better, not worse.
What should be getting better? Right.
Years, thousands of years ago, humans were in a better condition. They could live longer, right?
Well, humans didn't live longer. We lived shorter.
Thousands of years ago?
Oh, yeah, yeah. We lived a lot shorter lives. It's through science, through medicine, that we are able to live as long as we are today. The conditions get better. I mean, not too long ago, 40 was considered, you know, you're going to hit it pretty soon, you know, so, but we've now we're up to about 100, so.
There's some benefits, but there's also, look at autism, it's on the rise. Cancer is so prevalent, everyone knows someone that has cancer.
Well, cancer has always been an issue, you know.
Not as bad as it is now.
What's that?
Not as bad as it is now.
You think so? I can't comment on that because I haven't looked at what it used to be to what it is today, but logically, it would have to be probably better today than before, because now we can treat it more than we could before. So
if you get a chance, you should look that up, because it's better.
All right, but still, I mean, it's still, we're still evolving. I mean, you know DNA is right. I mean, we can see through DNA that, I mean, we used to be tree dwellers back in the day. We used to, you know, live in the trees, and then we came from the trees to the ground, and it's a long process. Okay.
With Bible teaching, we understand that humans were always humans. They didn't evolve from animals.
But the DNA shows we did evolve through other animals. We are animals. We're a primate, just like other apes are. You know, our closest relative is the chimpanzee. We share very common, very close DNA with. So we had common ancestors with the chimpanzee.
Do you believe in the Bible?
We'll see. The Bible is a book that we wrote, which doesn't really refer to science. Doesn't really have any science. And it was written before we knew about science.
It does have science in it.
Like what?
About the earth, that it hangs on nothing.
Okay, well, it doesn't hang. And it doesn't... And what is
exactly
nothing?
It doesn't hang on anything.
So then if it... So then that's not science.
They knew that the earth was round. They thought it was flat. But the earth, the Bible always said that it was...
No, it does, actually doesn't say that. It actually talks about four corners of the earth, and it doesn't actually refer to the earth as a sphere.
It does? In Isaiah?
No, it actually doesn't. If you looked it up, it doesn't actually say that.
Yeah, you read it.
Yeah, I have.
Actually, not to be in the Bible, but it's a quote.
Yeah.
There's a part in Isaiah where it talks about it being round, and then in Jonah, they talk about going to Tarshish, which they think is the end of the earth.
Yeah, they talk about circle of the earth, but not really sphere or anything like that. So
it's both him, and yeah. This is the problem with the Bible, is that there are... I study the Bible, so I'm not an expert. You probably know more than I do.
No.
I'm studying the Mike Grant stuff, so it's just funny. I just
wanted yeah.
It's good.
And, like, it's not that... It's not that it doesn't... Like, they don't have both. What the problem is that we like little boxes.
Yeah, so we look for something that fits, and then we say, oh, it talks about a circle. It must mean that the earth is round.
No. You know? It's both.
Yeah.
Also might mean that, like, this is as far as we've gone, or the end of the earth. We don't know.
Yeah.
And therein lies the problem, is that the way you interpret something relies heavily upon what, whether or not you think it's 100% factual, if you think it's told for a reason, and the problem with the Bible as a whole, the answer is yes. It's many different genres put together.
Yeah.
But it's, yeah, I think so. But it also tells a great story of God, which is true, which is very hard to put.
It tells you a great story of what?
It's really simple.
God, which is true.
God, which is what?
A higher power.
What is higher power?
A deity?
What is that?
God.
What is that?
The beginning.
Of what?
Everything.
Okay, I'm not getting any specifics from you.
I said a deity.
Okay, and what is that deity?
Yahweh.
Okay, you're giving me just a name. Yeah. What is it?
It's where everything started.
Okay, but what is it? You can't define something by what you think it's done, by what it is.
Right, and there have been attempts to describe it, but you can't.
Okay, so then why should anyone believe that it exists if we don't even know what it is? I mean, what are we actually believing in? If we say that there is a God, what does it actually say? What are we actually saying exists if we don't know what it is?
Can I interject?
Sure.
The air.
What about the air?
I can't see it, but there's a name to it.
Why do we need to use sight for air? There's many other different ways of measuring air. We can break out a barometer and measure the air.
Why do we need sight to measure God?
Why what?
Why do we need sight to measure God?
You can't.
I didn't say sight. I said we need evidence, any kind of evidence.
You are evidence.
How am I evidence for... No, my parents had sex. We went over this.
Yeah, but where did the egg come from?
What?
Where did the egg come from?
The female has the egg.
Where did all of that come from?
Okay, that's actually a named argument for that. It's called the argument of ignorance.
No, that sounds good.
Because it is. Because if someone asks you for evidence and you go and say, well, how else could it be? How else do you know? That's not actually answering the question. That's just saying, well, it couldn't happen anyway else, so then I must be true. It must be right.
Well,
that's not a way of arguing anything.
Well, then my question...
You got to step away from here.
Okay.
Now, because they're going to switch.
Your question is what?
My question to be then, like, are you familiar with the ontological argument?
Yeah, I'm familiar with all the arguments, yeah.
Yeah, the one where it says everything has a cause.
In the universe?
Yeah, so...
So, yeah, but that pertains to things in the universe, not the universe itself. Because the universe itself is comprised of a few things. It's just a word that describes space and time and energy
right.
And everything inside of it. So you can't really have a cause necessarily to the universe. Cause and effect are things described within the universe. You can't
right.
apply it to the whole universe itself.
Why not?
Well, how can you? Because then you have to... Because those are separate things. You have to do the cause and to time, to space, to all these things. And if we're going to talk about the singularity and things of that nature, well, then we're treading on what we don't really know.
Exactly.
So,
if
we don't know, we can't say God did it.
Well,
because that would be assuming.
Right. That would be.
So then nobody. Right. So nobody should wait. And faith is not a way of knowing anything, right?
Right. You're right. It's not a way of knowing anything.
So
but
if we
I do know, what I do know.
What's that?
The things that are caused by God.
But how do you know that God did anything? But we just said we don't know.
Right.
So then, how do you know that God did anything?
Right, guys. we'll get to talk again.
See you. Good. All right.
Book.
So you just believe what the book says?
Not really.
Do you think that's smart?
Plus, what I've experienced in my life, and from as far as I know,
experiences aren't really something you can use for determine the existence of something.
Well, then, how do you determine the existence of anything with experience?
I don't necessarily use experience. I use it through the means of testable evidence.
Testable evidence.
And we have nothing for any god.
Oh yeah, we do.
We have no evidence for any god.
There's
absolutely none.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Show me one. Tell me one.
Show you one.
Or tell me about one.
Are you familiar with mitosis?
With what?
Mitosis.
Okay, go ahead. What about it?
Are you familiar with it?
Heard of it? Yes.
Yes. You know the part where things disappear.
Okay.
No one knows why or where. It just disappears.
Okay.
We don't know why that happens, but it happens all the time.
You talking about quantum mechanics or what?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, not quantum mechanics. Yeah, basically.
Okay.
Where does it go? We don't know. Why then does that happen then if it's just random?
Okay, if we don't know something, that's no evidence of a god.
You're right.
Ignorance isn't evidence.
Right. Just like you don't know there isn't one.
Well, I don't have to know there isn't one. Whenever someone... It's whoever makes the positive assertion. If someone says that something exists, it's their burden of proof to show that it exists.
Right.
If they can't show it exists, it's not up to me to disprove it.
Right.
It's my correct position to be without belief until they come up with evidence.
Right. And I'm not doing this to be a dick.
What's that?
I'm not doing this to be a dick.
No, it's okay.
Yeah.
But I'm just trying to get to the point where
sure.
There's no reason to believe in a god. But you seem so certain when you said there is evidence, and I asked you for some, and then you referred to something that we don't know about, which really isn't any evidence. It's just you just said we don't know about something.
Well, you're right. I have faith.
Okay, and faith is not a way of knowing anything. It's without reason.
Yeah, it is.
If you had reason to believe in something, if you had evidence, you wouldn't use faith. I can use faith in invisible pink unicorns or Tinkerbell.
What about the one when my friend had termo cancer and he prayed and it went away?
Okay, that if that actually did happen, even though it's just a story, if that did action, that could be many things. Like your body can actually go into remission on itself. Anything could occur.
It could be God.
Well, it could be a leprechaun.
It could be a leprechaun.
But why would we believe in a God?
Because he prayed to God.
Okay, that's like saying I prayed to Joe Pesci and I got better. Does that mean Joe Pesci therefore cured me? No, not necessarily.
But how many people follow
it's like
Pesci?
It's like me, I crossed my fingers so I got better. Is it the act of crossing my fingers got me better? No, it's just coincidental.
Or it could have been that.
There has to be something directly showing a god cured a person other than just a story of someone curing and well they believed in a god or they prayed to God. That doesn't show us that a god did anything at all, right? How? How does it do that?
Because it's cured. It's done.
But how do you know a god did it, though? Where's the evidence that shows the link between a god and someone and that person curing?
It could be a dream.
Well, then we're back to square one where we don't have any evidence of any god, right?
Yeah.
You're assuming the evidence.
Strike that.
All right.
You don't have any existing evidence.
No, actually, no one has any evidence of God.
They do.
Who's they?
The person who had the dream.
They had a dream. People hallucinate and dream all the time. Dreams are not representative of reality. Most of the time.
I don't know, man.
Well,
you can't pull that card.
You have to have some solid evidence. You just can't come up with dreams and things we don't know about.
Okay, then how about people who have been self-actualized?
Explain.
Nelson Mandela.
What about it?
Man took an entire life and mobilized the nation.
Okay, what does that have to do with a god?
I think he did that all on his own.
Okay, see, your examples of a god rest on an argument from ignorance. If you don't know how it came to be, it must be God. That is a fallacious way of reasoning.
Actually, no. It's more of a... I see this, and this, and this.
Right. You assume a conclusion, which is not healthy. It is not healthy.
Well, then what would be your conclusion?
I don't need a conclusion.
Yeah,
I don't
do
need
that.
A conclusion. You asserted that God exists.
Acting stupid. And go talk to Scientology. They have hundreds of millions of dollars. And they are like, what the fuck is going on?
Go away, crazy person.
Really, I'm a crazy person.
Yeah, you're definitely a crazy person.
I'm 191.
You are fucking batshit crazy.
I am.
Alright.
You hear yourself, alright?
Alright, buddy.
I didn't mean to piss you off or anything.
You should what?
I didn't mean to piss you off.
He's an idiot.
Oh, it's okay, man. No problem. I just stopped for a minute.
Watch
see you later.
Moron, what are your thoughts from? And your bags. And don't forget to wear your headphones. Your beret.
Take your meds, lady.
Where is your
or jump off a building, one of the two.
I can do one day.
Crazy lady. What's that? I'm just looking to see what it is.
Yeah. Oh, okay. It's free information about the Bible.
The Bible.
This one's article is talking about how to get the most out of reading the Bible. A lot of people think it's this old book on the shelf that doesn't have any practical value, but actually...
What value does it have? Just old literature?
What was that?
Just good old literature?
Well, there is a lot of good old literature, but the Bible actually is a phenomenal book because it shows us how to live happy lives. It's moral values. It actually turns people's lives for the better. And not only that,
don't our morals come from us and not in a book we wrote back in the Bronze Age? Because morals evolve over time, right?
Well, that's,
you can't use a book written in the Bronze Age for morals today.
Well, let me ask you a question. If I said, hey, you should do unto others as you want others to do unto you.
That was around well before the Bible.
Well, actually, it's found in the Bible.
Right, but it was around before, right, because it was around before the Bible. Okay, but we don't need the Bible to tell us that because we already know that.
Okay, well,
some people do.
Some people do. And also, what's your name?
You might be
Ted.
Okay.
Ted.
Yeah. You obviously look like you got your S together. You got your stuff together.
Yeah.
I've got problems.
Well, I'm not sure. I'm not sure the Bible is going to give you.
Well, put it this way: would you stand out here and offer advice to me to help me with my life to have a life better like yours? Because they are. So that's why I'm talking to them.
So it's a matter of someone available on this specific street when we have Google and you can get help in a lot more places than right here in the street.
And I just was telling them that every time, like, they have a website, when I go to the website and I try to read stuff on my own, my mind and body wants to do other things. But, like, when I stand near these guys and I'm getting, like, a vibe from them, like,
yeah.
I mean, everybody has a vibe. You have a vibe, you know.
If you need help with something, I understand that that's an issue.
You live, like, what she was saying, because before this came together as a thing, it used to be eye for an eye.
What do you mean, eye for an eye?
An eye for an eye. Like, if I pushed you, you're going to...
What context are you speaking of?
Well, because you said that what she was saying was that that's been around for a long time, the golden rule. Like,
yeah,
to
sure.
Do unto others.
Yeah.
Right. But actually, before, it used to be like, basically, most people would live the kind of a thing of eye
no,
for
we
an
actually
eye.
Had, like, we actually had functioning
because,
societies.
Like, you have your morals, right? Like, we could easily, if you and I got into a discussion of, like, if they weren't here, and just somehow we bumped into each other for some reason, or I asked you a question, and
yeah.
A discussion, your morals of how you live might not click with mine based on my past experience, but how would that help either one of us of me trying to force you to do my morals or you trying to force me? Which one of us is right? If we have to...
Well, you'd have to use an example. I can't...
Well, what would be the most... Like, you want to survive. I want to survive. I don't want... I have no reason for you not to survive.
Okay,
you should have
you're talking about things that are helping you and you need assistance with things and such like that.
Right.
That's a totally separate issue on what they may have to offer you, because what they may have to offer could be founded on fallacious conclusions about how the world
that's
works.
But I haven't. They've been getting me to, like, this Bible here. Like, I was brought up Catholic, and I was kind of brought up in that, forced into it. You know, I went in the military, went around the world, seen things for myself, and tried to, you know, learn from things and what the kind of the question. My mother passed away in 2011. So there is this part of me that's like, you know, hey, look, just look around. What is there? There's life, there's death. You live, you die, enjoy yourself. Try to, you know, there is basic morals. Of
okay,
like
what are your...
So the question that I'm having, like, here's the question. Do you believe in ghosts?
I've never, what is a ghost?
Do you know what a ghost is?
That's why I'm asking. I don't think anyone knows what a ghost is.
Right, well... We've heard of it, but some people have
in movies and books.
Right, exactly. So what is the truth? What is the absolute truth?
The truth is we don't know what it is.
Right, so any religion, I've gone through all the different religions. This book was the one, my blood type is, like, I have a blood type. You have a blood type. You know your blood type?
Why are you talking about blood types?
I'm going to bring this up.
Okay.
I'm going to get to a point. My blood type is AB positive.
Okay.
Okay, so the point of this, it's kind of a long story, but what I'm going to try to make it short was that I learned from their book more than I did from my other religions and sciences that if I want to get into...
Why are you looking to religion for answers?
Well, they have information that gives me something that's more than science, because I'm a scientist.
Why would you want more... What do you mean by more than science?
Okay, so, like I said, like spirit... Concepts that are like metaphysical concepts. Like you study like tachyons, gluons, muons.
Okay, metaphysical is not scientific.
Wait. So if we get into science and we start talking about things like ether and plasma, we have those things in our body. And what I learned was that spiritual practices, scientifically, we can create what's called a ghost that can lead.
I have a feeling you won't be able to give a foundation for any of that.
Right, so your blood type, I'm going to guess, is that your blood type is O positive.
Why would my blood type be O positive?
Because most blood...
What are you treating blood types like an astrological sign or something?
It's very close to that.
Yeah, no, it's not. It's not O negative.
Right, do you know eHarmony?
Yeah, it's a shitty site. Yeah.
I looked at their patent. He's a doctor. He matches people by what's called the major histocompatibility complex.
Okay.
It's chromosomes from your parents.
Why would you look to religion for assistance?
Well, this, not just religion. I've gone to a lot of religions. This
why go to any religion for assistance?
Let me finish. I'm trying to tell you. Keep stopping me.
you go far away on this long tangent.
Because you keep stopping me. This one, this Bible, the one there, and they don't trade blood, basically. They don't take blood from people. They don't give their
blood. Which is bad.
Right.
Which is bad.
Right.
Really bad.
So I'm asking them questions. Why do you believe what you believe?
Because it says so in their book.
Right, right. So, like, the modern-day word for blasphemy would be slander, mocking, defamation of character, or, like, betrayal. So, like, if someone betrays your trust...
Okay, can you just, like, do short synopsis points?
I'm trying to, but you keep getting me...
I don't know, you go, like, way...
I'm trying to go on a thing, and then you ask me a question about something, what I'm talking about. The point was that I got into the blood type thing to find out, is there... anything in my chemistry, because people say chemistry, right? Have you ever heard someone say that?
You go off here, and then you go here, and then you go there.
My plane, okay, if you give me a chance. So I'm trying to figure, because my blood type is rare, it's AB positive. I can receive everyone's blood, but nobody can receive mine. President JFK was AB positive.
Okay, what's your point?
His wife was O negative, Marilyn Monroe was AB positive. So blood... I did a study of Jesus and the blood and blood types and things like that, and how chemistry is the doorway between the
physical
and the spiritual.
I have no idea. I don't know. We don't know what spiritual is, dude.
So that's what I'm saying.
It's a word we made up. It can be defined differently for different people.
Right. That's why I said, because this is telling me that if you blaspheme spirit or hold sacred things... How do you feel about water? Do you drink water a lot? You look pretty healthy. Do you drink a lot of water?
I think I do. What's your point, dude? You're
holy.
Like...
Holy is clean, pure.
You sound like someone that can sit down and just ramble on, and then you'll forget the first question you asked.
Okay.
I asked you, because you went on so long about two different,
you're
things.
Me, and that's what I'm saying. I'm in a process. I'm
okay.
Not there yet.
Clearly.
Obviously, you have the answers for life, for your life. You said you've got your morals... You know, you don't need...
I didn't say I had the answers for my life. Right. I don't know what that means.
Well, I mean, you stopped and said that this book is basically like, it's like literally, it's old literature.
Old literature, right.
I'm sorry, because I'm not going to be here much longer. I didn't want to finish my conversation with them. Thank you so much for stopping by. I did want to talk to you, though, briefly. I don't know if you can continue your conversation with
him. I mean, I don't want to stop him. I don't want to bother him.
I was going by and I saw this, and I just wanted to know, with all the bad things in the Bible... Do you just ignore all the bad things and only pay attention to good things, or what?
When you say bad things, what do you mean?
Like slavery?
Like with the Israelites.
A lot of slavery support in the Bible. And there's the killing of the infidels is in the Bible, too.
So I want to ask you, have you actually read the Bible yourself?
Yes, I have.
Okay, mm-hmm. Because if you read the Bible yourself, you see that the Bible isn't supporting slavery, but it's giving history of what happened to a certain type of people.
No, it actually teaches you how to treat your slaves and stuff
how,
like
that.
Oh, I'd have to pull out my phone and look it up and stuff like that.
Are
you saying that those things don't exist in
the
Bible?
King James. They have a different version. That's King James.
Oh, they ignore it? Oh, different version.
Even the Catholic Bible has different books like Tobit and Wisdom and things like that.
So they just edited that out. That's right. This is written by that James. What was it?
Which deals with a black woman.
What was it, James Smith
or
something?
It's an interracial story, actually.
But that's not just. It's actually part of the original Bible canon, which is in the Bible.
Oh, okay. Yes.
Well, let me ask you this, the base question here. Why do you believe that your Bible is telling you the truth about God and stuff like that?
Why do I believe the Bible is telling me?
So, truth about God.
Whether it's my Bible, as you claim, I can take any Bible and read it and examine it. And when you look at it, this book, which was written thousands of years ago, you can go to any museum.
Well, I don't think your book was written thousands of years ago.
You
but
can go to any museum. I've been to Ireland. I've checked it out. You can see these actual manuscripts, which are hand-copied.
Okay.
From these men, and everything that was written at those particular times
is
true.
Even
and
if that's true.
What I mean, I'm going to finish my question.
Okay, go ahead.
I'm sticking to the point.
All right.
And what I mean is, you can go to modern theologians and historians, and you can compare what's in the Bible as opposed to what happened really in history. And guess what? It always lines up, even when history says, hey.
But what does that have to do with a God existing, though?
When history says, hey, this didn't happen, the Bible says this, and it happened 50 years later, 600 years later,
okay.
The Bible shows...
There's no predictions in the Bible.
There's no predictions
in the Bible.
And that's your opinion, and I'll let you keep
But
that.
Even if there was predictions in the Bible, how does that pertain... How does that pertain to a God existing? Let's say I predict someone's going to win the lottery next week, and then I have an additional assertion that unicorns are real. If that person won the lottery, no. If that person won the lottery, is my other assertion that unicorns are real, therefore true, because I predicted the lottery for that person.
Can I say something real quick? Do you do any religious practices?
I'm not religious, no.
Okay, so religious.
Well, no. Can I get her to answer? Because you'll go on forever. You'll go on forever.
Because he's not. God is for blood type O people.
Hold on.
I do have to go, Ted. But thank you for
stopping. No, but you said you were telling me.
I was. And you were talking about certain prophecies and how to believe. If you say, hey, this is going to happen next week and it just happens to happen, does that make
so,
true?
So you believe in a God because you think there's some predictions that are true. Therefore, you think God's true.
Whether the Bible, we have the Bible or not,
right.
Why
would you believe in
from
a creator?
Science, actually.
Well, how does science support a creator?
Now, when you think about it, here's our Earth in the middle of this amazing galaxy, right?
We're not in the middle, but okay.
You're right. In the galaxy.
In fact, we're always moving.
We are. In this ever-expanding galaxy. Can you say that?
I don't think it's ever expanding, but...
Okay. In the galaxy? Do you agree with
the
that?
Galaxy? We're just one galaxy.
Okay, so...
The ever-expanding universe, I think, is what you meant to say. That could be true. But the galaxy is always moving.
Everything about this Earth, how
yes.
it is, I study architecture. And I know that if I look at any building, I know that there took a mind and a designer behind it.
Okay, you're talking about man-made structures.
I'm talking about man-made structures. So if it takes a mind, a smart mind, to put something together,
yes.
how much more so for our Earth that we support?
Okay, so you're saying everything is you're saying everything is created, nothing is natural. So then nothing's natural. If everything's created, then nothing's natural. Then how can we say anything is not... How can we say anything... Natural means not created. If everything is created, then nothing is natural.
Okay, so that's your...
So you're using your opinion that because the world seems like it was created, therefore you think there's a God.
What's your opinion? That's your opinion, that there's not a God.
Well, my opinion... No, my stance is there's no evidence... there's no evidence of a God, so you can't believe in one. But you're using your opinion that, well, everything looks created, so therefore there must be a creator. But that's an opinion. That's not evidence that supports a God.
And it's the same with evolution. There's no evidence that supports evolution.
Do you know what evolution is?
What's evolution to you?
I'll take that as you don't know what evolution is. Evolution is a change in the gene pool of a given species over one or more generations. This is factual. What occurs. It's supported both by fossils and DNA. A theory is a conclusion based on facts. Do you know what a theory is? A theory is
by not only your hypothesis but also evidence, and they have to have proof. And science,
yes.
even though despite that, has not to prove that evolution.
Evolution is as concrete as gravity.
And I'm glad you have that opinion.
It's not an opinion. That's factual. You don't even know what evolution is. I just explained it to you, and you don't. Do you know anything about DNA?
Well, see, now you're getting on my territory. You said I'm nonsense, though. That's where I'm getting is I'm trying to get deeper into chemistry to find out what's the...
Oh, sorry, I didn't mean to say you're nonsense. I'm just saying
I know
the tangents you were going off to led me to not follow you.
Because I'm putting all these things together. I'm trying to make a four-dimensional picture, and it's all these.
So all JWs don't believe in evolution. You as factual as it is, you don't believe in it. Nobody does. You don't think evolution is factual. Do you know about DNA? Evolution is extremely factual. Extremely factual. There is so much evidence for evolution. It's crazy. Do you know our DNA is very much like a chimpanzee? So we have common ancestors with the chimpanzee. Do you know why chimpanzees have 48 chromosomes and we only have 46? Because two of them fuse together. You can see that. You can see the relation that we have. You'd have to do homework into DNA and evolution. But you're not going to do that if you're here scared to do it because you think that your God is going to be unhappy with you.
But why?
But you haven't, because you just don't. You told me you don't even know what a theory is.
No. Oh, sorry. I explained what a theory was and you agreed.
You said evolution is just a theory. Right, just like gravity, a theory of gravity.
It's not a theory of gravity, it's a gravity force.
No, gravity is also a theory.
Is it?
Yes.
I
it is. Your ignorance of science is astounding, ma'am. It's astounding.
Thank you so much for your time.
Yes.
Really.
Yeah.
I hope you have a good day today.
Oh, I'm always going to have a good day.
That's great.
Thank
that's
you.
Awesome. I hope everyone has a good day.
Yes. Well, I wish you would get more of an education. Are all JWs like as ignorant about science as you are? Yeah, I've seen it. You don't really have any science on there.
Well, we actually do. We have renowned scientists who are on our website.
Yeah. Well, apparently you don't know of any of their work.
I hope you have that data.
Yeah, I will. Thanks. I will.
I feel like you guys are arguing because you're both just not on the same page. Like, if you guys were to, like, get together and actually talk about stuff rather than just...
Well,
like,
see, in her camp, she's against science.
Because she's here for a purpose. I mean, your purpose is opposite of her purpose. That's why I honestly, like, I swear, that's why I said, like, I learned more from, like, blood types and learning about that, of why people just don't get to... Cause, and you're going to probably say this is like a hocus pocus. It is mostly theory. But all these theories
you mean
are
hypothesis.
Together starting to fit into a puzzle. Like, when you, if you got a puzzle out of a box, right?
I don't know what you're getting at.
I'm going to ask you, have you ever gotten a puzzle?
Okay, I don't. The questions aren't going to help me understand.
Well, then that's your problem then.
I don't.
I'm trying to understand, like, you brought up DNA. Right?
What's and that?
So have you ever heard people say, like, relationships, like, they want to have chemistry in a relationship? So chemistry is science, right? But it can also sound like a word that doesn't mean anything. But the amino acid proteins in your mitochondrial DNA are different than the proteins in your nuclear DNA, which is what eHarmony matches people by. That's nuclear DNA. It's basically a platonic relationship based on chromosome values that have more to do with your immune system than it does with your actual chemistry that you transfer through kissing. Did you know that the iris of your eye is identical to your mitochondrial circular genome map?
Okay, well, this is
so, you
great.
Know, like they say, the eyes are the window.
I got paged, so I gotta go, bro. Okay. Thank you, though. I have a job to do. It's been crazy anti-science talk here.
I'm trying to talk science. You didn't want to listen to the science.
This lady doesn't know anything about evolution. Apparently no JW knows much about evolution.
Because this is coming from a standpoint of using a different part of you.
I don't know what that means, bro. You can't be vague like that when you're having a discussion. It doesn't work.
Well, okay, so do you know, like, all
being another part of you that
do
doesn't
you know what the pineal gland does?
Okay, now you,
there you
yeah, I know. All right, take care. Good day, ladies and gentlemen. This is Ted, the Atheist. Just thought I'd do a little vlogging at the end of my Splice videos. I have a new device I've been using. I have my ACM-16. You guys have seen it. My electric cycle. I need to show that. And for my video, I've been using Foream X1.
Got this from China. Took quite a few weeks to get it. Got it off Amazon. Anyway, it's great. Someone online told me about it, and so I got it. And you can set it so none of the lights turn on when you're using it. So people might notice that you got something on there, but they don't. It's not like you're holding something in your hand. So the lights are off. Blends in with my hat. I wear a hat here. And, it works great. And I just connect it to my computer after and just transfer just drag and drop. And it's really nice. So that's what I use. And so a couple times now you've seen that no one asks any questions. So I think you'll see me doing a lot better videos without having to hold my camera and shit, and you'll see everything. So I invested a little bit in my camera taking skills and my video taking skills. So hopefully you guys will appreciate that. And again, just a bunch of AJWs. That last lady just didn't know shit about evolution, yet she was so against it. Trust me, if I can get a hold of Muslims, I would. Scientologists seem to have vacated downtown LA, which is cool. I hate those fuckers. Now that I have this thing, I might head down to the headquarters in Hollywood just to fuck with them. I've rode around with my EUC around their headquarters, and their people with bikes will stop and ask questions. So I see that as an opportunity to fuck with them. And I think I'm going to do that, especially with the new camera they're not going to know is on. So it's going to be fun. I'll probably do that sometime, maybe next weekend, since I was on call this weekend. So I was getting paged quite a bit, some issues going on. So I wasn't able to go out and do much. But for two more weeks, I won't be on call. So, anyways, hope you guys enjoy it. I had to use Sony Vegas to cut out all the bullshit writing and just put the debates or the entertainment, shall I say, in there, not really debates. Hope you guys, I type a little bit of my writing in there. That thing I ride is a fuck ton of a lot of fun, guys. So if you guys can afford it, grab a AMC 16 is what it's called. I'm sure in a couple of years it'll be even better, but it's a hell of a lot of fun to ride around, and it's so much better. Other than that, I was very surprised that lady. You know, you see the mistake all the time they make about calling evolution a theory, like they don't know what the hell they're talking about. I don't know where to even begin with that. It's really hard to. Not that it's difficult, but it's just the ignorance, stupidity, it's just hard to deal with sometimes. And the other guy before her, he was obviously getting tripped up. Hey, it looks like I have about almost 10,000 viewers, and it's not too much, but for me it's a lot. I don't do too much for my channel. I just record some videos and slap them on there. Now I'm having to use Sony Vegas to put everything together because I think my camera only does it in half a gig to a gig and a half, or sometimes 3 gigs. I think it's kind of arbitrary how it decides how big the file size is going to be. I got to grab different file sizes and slap them together and edit them. Not really edit them, but cut out the bullshit. And it's not one continuous file like I have in my phone. So it takes a little more effort to put a video up now, but I'll keep doing it whenever I get something good. So peace, logic. Where's Dusty? You guys seen his videos much? I didn't really see too many of his videos. Tell me what you guys think. Oh, I have a lot of you fuckers. I gotta say something. Got some efforts coming on to my channel, like, oh, you need to shoot a epistemology, you gotta do that. And, you know, heckling these motherfuckers is not the way to do it. Blah, 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 blah. You know, if your motherfucking ass wants to get a goddamn camera and do your goddamn salt, go the fuck ahead. But don't think that everyone's the same. Not everyone's the same. So not everyone's going to respond to the same type of content. They're just not. So, I mean, you can sit there and think, oh, everyone's going to listen to you if you're just very calm and, you know, you're very fluffy with their feelings and you get them to... No, it doesn't work that way. You've got to metaphorically slap people. You know, sometimes, and it works, and it's what I do. I'm not, you know, sometimes I might sit around and talk to someone about something in a calm way. Sometimes I don't. It really depends on what I'm getting back from the person. You know, I react to what I get. So, you know, don't come on my fucking channel and tell me about street epistemology like I've never fucking heard of it before. All right, thanks. Do your own fucking channel, bitch. Jizza. Peace.